The Devil's Chamber by Jake Krogan. This is such a stupid idea. Why are we even doing this? Those were the thoughts that arose in my mind on that chilly, eerie evening, sitting in the passenger side of the dimly lit car which belonged to my best friend Matt. I peered out the window and glanced up at the beautiful yet ominous night sky. The moon was huge and luminous. I looked at my watch. It was just about midnight, a time when most normal people would already be in bed. I glanced over at Matt, who was gleefully driving to our destination, seemingly unaware of how stupid this whole thing was. "Why are we doing this, Matt? You know nothing's gonna happen," I said, slightly annoyed at the entire situation. Matt looked at me with aggravation. "You agreed to come, so stop being whiny and try to have some fun," he snapped. After about 5 more minutes of driving, Matt stopped the car abruptly. "Here we are," he proclaimed with genuine excitement. He then turned to me and corrected himself. "Well, almost. We have to do a little walking." I followed Matt as we walked down a steep grassy hill and ended up in the woods. Pitch black. "I can't see a thing," I exclaimed.
"Don't worry, dude, I brought a flashlight."
He pulled a small flashlight out of his jeans pocket. We continued through the woods for what seemed like an hour. Finally, we arrived in front of a vast, deep tunnel. I looked at Matt. "The hell is this thing?"
"The Devil's Chamber. Here we are. Let's go," Matt said, dangerously eager to go inside the death trap.
I stopped him. "Whoa, whoa, whoa. We're not gonna go in there, are we? We're gonna kill ourselves. What if the flashlight dies? What if there's someone else in there?
What if you stop being such a loser and just walked in?"
my friend interrupted in a half-joking tone.
"Come on. Let's go."
I reluctantly followed him into the tunnel. It was cold, dark, and damp. Insects were everywhere, not to mention all the dead rats, mice, and of course the occasional decaying cat. There were all sorts of graffiti covering the walls. I instantly felt something very strange throughout my body. It felt as if a bubble of negative energy was trying to push itself into me. I was overwhelmed with a sense of dread. However, I remembered how damn excited Matt was to be here, so I kept my mouth shut and continued to follow behind him. As we reached the middle of the tunnel, Matt pulled out his camera and decided to take a few pictures. For the next couple of minutes, all I heard was the loud snap of Matt's camera, paired with a flash that nearly blinded me. Suddenly, I felt a small hand on my shoulder. I quickly turned around, but of course nobody was behind me. I shrugged it off and kept walking. Maybe it was a bug, I thought, in an attempt to calm my nerves. The tunnel became colder and darker the farther we walked. "How long is this tunnel?" I asked Matt. He turned to me and smiled.
"Would you relax? We'll turn back in a minute."
I noticed that he was beginning to feel a bit nervous.
"You're right, though. We have been walking for a while. Let's turn around."
We began to walk back to the entrance. I couldn't wait to get out. As we were walking, I abruptly heard something that sounded like a young girl's laughter. Then, I felt it again, the hand on my shoulder, the same small, childlike hand. This time, it was more assertive, like something was really trying to get my attention. Again, I tried to tell myself that it was probably just a bug or something. I just wanted to get the hell out of this place. Finally, after what seemed like hours, we reached the entrance and quickly walked outside. We hurried through the woods and up the hill, glancing over our shoulders every so often to make sure nothing was following us. At last, we arrived at Matt's car. I wasted no time opening the passenger door and hopping in. Matt then got inside after me and started the car. He pulled his camera out of his backpack.
All right, let's see what we got, he said with a radiant grin. The two of us looked carefully at every picture. Nothing, just a bunch of concrete, dirt, and spiders. Then, we came across a picture of me standing in front of Matt. We both looked closely and gasped. There was a small childlike hand gently resting on my shoulder.